So what's going on with a robot? While I wish we could tell you we got working, that just isn't the case. Since we're not just doing YouTube for fun anymore, and we're actually running a business, we have to choose the projects we work on very carefully. And while it may have been possible to fix up this robot, it would have taken hundreds and hundreds of hours, at the very minimum. And when you're running a business, hundreds of hours equates to thousands of dollars. So literally, if we kept working on this, we probably could have bankrupted the business, and that's not worth it. Besides, I'm sure there are other projects you'd prefer us to waste our time on. Now, quite a few of you guys realized it probably wasn't that feasible for us to actually fix this robot. And I gotta admit, when I first got it, I was probably being a bit more optimistic than I should have been, because the more and more we looked at the robot, we realized we made a mistake. These were the problems we knew about. Number one, no connector cables. These are very expensive and would have been very time consuming to make our own. Number two, the controller forgot what robot it was connected to. So even if we succeeded in connecting the robot to the controller, it might not have even worked. Number three, the robot wasn't even in guaranteed working condition when we bought it. Number four, we don't even have three-phase 400 volt power in the shop. And probably a whole bunch of other issues we haven't even discovered yet. So we made the executive decision to can the project. But there is a silver lining. We were able to salvage a whole bunch of parts out of the controller and the motor, including expensive relays, servo motors, and a bunch of other stuff. All in all, we were able to scrap more than $500 worth of stuff, which, if I can remind you, is actually how much we paid for the robot in the first place. And we still have the robot, which is probably worth around $1,000 in scrap metal alone. But before we do that, I've got a better idea. Let's turn into the shop mascot.
There's ice cream sandwiches in the fridge, if you want one.
So the audience sees that I'm not the only one who doesn't do any work.
Here we go.
out of the box.
What?
Did you not see the problem with what you just did?
I just said pull it out.
You're kicking me.
It's on a brick.
It'll be on your foot.
I'm gonna put my foot under it.
That's what happens when you kick it.
No.
And you were kicking the board, not the cinder block.
Okay. All right, lift it up.
I want a better block now.
The brick break?
That's a solid brick.
Hooray!
How's that going? See? Wobble it? Oh, that's pretty good. I wouldn't suggest that, though, yet. So, see?
No, look. You broke the plastic.
Bogdan!
I'm the one that put it on there.
Fix it. You broke it. Look. You actually destroyed the plastic up there.
Come on, Bogdan.
I'm gonna fix this.
What do you have to say for yourself?
Fix it. I can fix it again.
Let's push a
1,000-pound robot on the plastic part.
Black new.
There's a new gap there.
Where?
That would have been black if it wasn't in my place.
I think he's trolling you at this point.
I don't know. I think it fit better before.
Wait. We need to. Bogdan, you need to stand right underneath it. No, you have to look at me. You know how video characters have their names floating above with them?
No way.
Not bad, huh? We're thinking about turning it into a place for other YouTubers to autograph when they come do collabs with us. Unfortunately, we've already missed a few. Colin Furze, Zednot Alpha, Everything Apple Pro, Jairus of All, MakeMe.org, Omar Youssef. But anyways, all future collabs, we're gonna get them to sign this and eventually it's gonna be covered in YouTuber signatures, which I think is pretty cool. Plus, there's another bit of silver lining. Doing these videos got us a lot of exposure. And some robotics companies might actually be interested in providing us a working robot for the shop to use as a robotic helper. So stay tuned for that, and hopefully we'll have a robot that actually works here.